السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر.
يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters, apologies for the delay. But the topic of today's khutbah is how to continue progressing in Iman after Ramadan. That if a person wants a short formula as to how they can improve in their deen, it is related to their Iman. The higher a person's iman is, the better their actions are. And the better their actions are, the more Allah is pleased with them. And the lower their iman is, the worse their actions are. And the worse of the actions leads to the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ يَهْدِيهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِإِيمَانِهِمْ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ فِي جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحياتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. In short, this is not a word-for-word translation, but the key to entering into Jannah is al-Iman. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told Umar ibn al-Khattab in the hadith of Sahih Muslim, that يا عمر اذهب فنادي في الناس أنه لا يدخل الجنة إلا المؤمنون. That oh Umar, go and announce to the people that only the believers will enter al-Jannah. We heard Quran a lot in Ramadan, And what is the sign of listening to the Quran for the believer? It increases their iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that وَإِذَا مَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ أَيُّكُمْ زَادَتْهُ هَذِهِ إِيمَانًا فَأَمَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَهُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that for some, showing the difference between the believers and the hypocrites, when the Quran is revealed, they ask each other, which one of you increased in iman through this? So the believers, they say, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَزَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. As for those who believe, it increases them iman, وَهُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ, and they rejoice. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَتْهُمْ رِجْسًا إِلَى رِجْسِهِمْ وَمَاتُوا وَهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Allah says, as for those who have the disease of hypocrisy in their heart, when the Quran is revealed to them, it increases the disease and the filthiness of their heart. And they die in the state of fisq. So anyhow, that was the introduction. So there's a very famous canonical work on this topic, which could take years and years to read. Imam Ibn al-Bayhaqi, he wrote Shu'ab al-Iman. From the one hadith of the Prophet, when he said, al-Iman al-Bid'a'un wa sab'una shu'abah, that faith is, in one riwayah, Situna Bid'a'un Situn, 63 to 69 branches, and another narration, 73 to 79 branches. Like iman is a tree, and you see a tree, when it has good roots and it's irrigated, its branches yield fruit. So when a believer has these qualities and actions in their life, the fruit of good actions come in their life, the actions of the body and the heart and the rida of Allah. Allah, he says that, وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا كُلَّ حِينٍ مِنْ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهَا وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he explained this ayah. Allah, he says, the example of a good speech is like a good tree. And this speech, he says, is like the shahada la ilaha illallah. أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ, its roots are firm in the ground, which is the faith of the believer. وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ, and its branches go to the sky. And he interpreted, he said that the good actions of the believer, they ascend to Allah in the heavens, and Allah accepts from them. But the essence is our faith, that we cannot make an excuse and say, oh, we don't live in a Muslim country. Allah, he says, يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّ أَرْضِي وَاسِعَةٌ فَإِيَّايَ فَاعْبُدُونَ, that, oh, my servants, my earth is vast, my land is vast, but wherever you are, worship me and obey me. There is no excuse wherever we may be. So in order to increase that, we have to increase our iman. That the Sahaba radiallahu anhu is mentioned, Umar radiallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Rawaha, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, many of them, they used to say to their brother, Ta'ala nu'min bi Rabbina sa'a, let us have a gathering where we renew our faith and we talk about al-ghayb, the unseen, and increase our iman. So anyway, we will only cover a few of those branches today, inshallah. So from them is al-iman bi wujubi muhabbati Allah, to believe in the necessity of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one of the excellent, best actions a believer can do with their heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّ لِلَّهِ, that those who believe, they are intense in their love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ بِهِنَّ حَلَوَةَ الْإِيمَانِ, whoever has these three qualities, they will find the sweetness of iman in their heart. The sweetness of iman is something that once, I believe it was Qadi Abu Yusuf rahimahullah and Ibrahim ibn Adham, they were on the bank of the Euphrates or Tigris River in Iraq, and they had a piece of old bread, stale dry bread, and they dipped it in the river because they had no other food to eat, and they ate that, and they told each other that if the kings and the princes knew what we feel in the sweetness of iman, they were trying to cut our skin to take it from us. The halawa of iman is something that nothing in this world can compare to. Allah, the Prophet said, whoever has these three qualities, they will find the halawa of iman. أَنْ يَكُونَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا سِوَهُمْ. The first quality, that you love Allah and His Messenger more than anyone else. This comes first, before our family, before ourselves. النَّبِيُّ أَوْلَى بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. وَإِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَالْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِي الْغَدَمْ. It's a long ayah in Surah Tawbah. Allah says, if 8 things come to you in love before Allah and His Messenger and striving for His religion, then you should wait for the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the love of Allah azza wa jal. And what is the sign somebody loves Allah? Is that they obey Him. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, he said, تَعْصِ الْإِلَهَ وَأَنْتَ تُظْهِرُ حُبَّهُ. You disobey Allah and you claim you love Him. إن هذا الأمر في عالي بديع. This is something very strange. لو كنت صادقا في حبه لا طاعته. If you were a true lover, you would obey Allah. إن المحب لمن يحب مطيع. The one who loves someone, they obey their beloved. Next is, and we don't have time to explain them, الخوف من الله. To have fear of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He says, فأما من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى. Allah mentioned two things. You want to go to Jannah? Fear the position of your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear standing in front of Him on the Day of Judgment and suppress your ego from its evil desires. فإن الجنة هي المأوى. Allah gave معاقبة فاء and then تأكيد for sure the abode of this person is Jannah. Another is رجاء. To believe that the hope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mandatory. It is haram to lose hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهِ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah said, all servants of mine, say to them, O Muhammad, servants of mine who have transgressed the limits of sins, don't ever despair in the mercy of your Lord. The Prophet said in a scary hadith, narrated by Sahih Muslim, that لَوْ يَعْلَمُ الْمُؤْمِنْ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنَ الْعُقُوبَةِ مَا طَمِعَ بِجَنَّتِهِ أَحَدٌ. That if a believer knew what Allah had in store in punishment and torment, no one would have hope in his Jannah. And the other opposite, لَوْ يَعْلَمُ الْكَافِرُ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ. If the disbeliever knew how much mercy Allah had, مَا قَنِطَ مِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ أَوْ مَا قَنِطَ مِنْ جَنَّتِهِ أَحَدٌ. That nobody would lose hope in the mercy and Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول ما تسمعون فاستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله على عباده الذين اصطفى ما بعد. So respected brothers and sisters, to conclude is that what is the sign of the best of Iman and what is the sign of the lowest of Iman? That Imam Abu Bakr al-Ajuri rahimahullah, he has a chapter in his book Al-Sharia, and he says, بَابُ ذِكْرِ مَا دَلَّ عَلَى زِيَادَةِ الْإِيمَانِ وَالنُقْصَانِ. That what is, that indicates the increase of Iman and the lowest of Iman. So the Prophet he said that the highest branch of Iman is فَأَعْلَاهَا شَهَادَةُ وَكَلِمَةُ لَا إِلَهِ. So say La ilaha, that is the highest branch of Iman. وَأَدْنَاهَا إِمَانَ تَطْفُ الْأَذَى عَنِ الطَّرِيقِ. The lowest branch of Iman, if you see a harmful object in the pathway, in the road, the sidewalk, you remove it. وَالْحَيَاءُ شُعْبَةٌ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. أي وَالْحَيَاءُ شُعْبَةٌ عَظِيمَةٌ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. And one of the largest or vital branches of Iman, the Prophet said, is Al-Hayat, to have modesty and bashfulness. So anyway, what indicates the increase of Iman and the decrease? That he mentions, rahimahullah, and it comes in Sunan al-Tirmidhi with the authentic chain from Abu Huraira that the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنَ إِذَا أَذْنَبَ كَانَتْ نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدَاءُ فِي قَلْبٍ. The believer, when he does a sin, a black dot comes into his heart. And this blackness is not indicating that black is negative. That to Allah, the colors of our skin are equal. Allah, He said, وَمِنَ الْجِبَالِ جُدَدٌ بِيضٌ وَحُمْرٌ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهَا وَغَرَابِيبُ سُودٌ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ وَالدَّوَابِ وَالْأَنْعَامِ مُخْتَلِفٌ أَلْوَانُهُ كَذَلِكَ إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ غَفُورٌ. That the way you see in the soil and the rocks, there's, you know, a white color, a red color, a black color. Allah, He said, similarly, He made those colors amongst humanity and the creatures that roam the earth. So anyhow, when a believer does a sin, a black dot comes onto his heart. فَإِذَا تَابَ وَنَزَعَ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ. If he repents and he stops doing that sin and seeks forgiveness, صُفِرَ مِنْهَا قَلْبُ. His heart is polished. It becomes white and polished. فَإِنْ زَادَ زَادَتْ حَتَّى تَعْلُ قَلْبَهُ. But if he increases in that sin, those black dots increase and increase upon his heart. فَذَٰلِكَ الرَّانِ. And that is what Allah described as the rust on the hearts in Surah Al-Mutaffifin. That كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Today people do all the sins under the sky, and if you tell them with ikhlas and wishing well for them to leave this sin and fear Allah, they will say, brother, my heart is good. That's all that matters. Sister, my heart is good. But the true indication of a sound heart is actions. If the actions are done, and that is, we only know the zahir, Allah knows the batin. We don't know the intention. None of us know who is sincere and insincere. But if you give the example, like one of my friends said, imagine somebody was sitting on the bench for, you know, the Golden State Warriors all season. They had 0 points, zero rebound, zero assist, zero steals, zero block, 0 minute, and they get MVP. Is that gonna happen? In Islam, to have a sound heart, this is one of the greatest things you can have. On the day of judgment, our children, our sons and children, and wealth will not help us except he who comes to Allah with a sound heart. Allah, he praised Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَإِنَّ مِنْ شِيَعَتِهِ لَإِبْرَاهِيمِ إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Allah said from the likes of Nuh was Ibrahim, as Allah mentioned their stories in Surah Safat. إِذْ جَاءَ رَبَّهُ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. When he came to his Lord with a sound heart. Do we know how many tests Ibrahim went through, alayhi salam? But through those tests, Allah praised him and said he had a sound heart. So anyhow, respected brothers and sisters, to conclude is one lesson that Abdurrahman ibn Abdul Khalid, al-Mu'allim, rahimahullah, one of the present day scholars, he has an amazing commentary on Surah Yusuf. And when the brothers of Yusuf, alayhi salam, when they wanted to get rid of their brother, and then be the ones that their father loved more, what did they say? That وَتَكُونُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ قَوْمًا صَالِحِينَ قَالُوا قَالَ قَائِلٌ مِنْهُمْ لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ وَأَلْقُوهُ فِي غَيَابَةِ الْجُبِّ يَلْتَقِطْهُ بَعْضُ السَّيَّارَةِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ فَاعِلِينَ. That before they decided to throw him in the well, they said قَالُوا اقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ, kill Yusuf, أَوْ اطْرَحُوهُ أَرْضًا, or leave him in a deserted land. يَخْلُو لَكُمْ وَجْهُ أَبِيكُمْ, your father will be sincere in his love for you. وَتَكُونُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِ قَوْمًا صَالِحِينَ. And after that, you will become righteous. They thought it was easy. They're going to go back to their right, the good ways after this sin. But now that shaitan is let loose, the imam, he says that إِنَّ الْعَاصِي حِينَ يَعْزَمُ عَلَىٰ اِرْتِكَابِ الذَّنْبِ يُزَيِّنُ لَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذَنْبِ. That when the disbeliever, he makes the intention to do a sin, that shaitan beautifies and decorates that sin for him. يُطَمِّعُهُ بِالتَّصْرِيفِ. He gives him long hopes and desire that you can procrastinate your righteous action. وَيُهَيِّئْ لَهُ الْمَنَاقُ الزَّمَنِ الطَّوِيلِ بِتَسْوِيفِ التَّوْبَةِ بَعْدَ أَنْ يُبِعَهُ فِي مُشْتَنْقِعَ الْمَعَصِيمِ. And then shaitan, what he does is, he prepares for this person a long time of procrastination that they will make tawbah afterward, after they had done that sin. فَيَتَحَقَّقُ لَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ أُمْنِيَتَهُ مِنْ إِقَاعِ الْعَبْدِ فِي الْمَعْصِيمِ. Then shaitan fulfills his goal of putting that slave in a sin. فَكَانَ أَغْرَبُ أُولَادِ يَعْقُوبِ أَمْنِيَتِهِ. The sons of Ya'qub, they had two deluded hopes. They said that أَنَّ وَالِدَكُمْ سَيَصِفُ قَلْبُهُ وَيُحِبُّكُمْ بَدْلًا مِنْ يُوسِفُ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ. Your father, he will have pure love in his heart for you in replacement of Yusuf, and he will even love you more than Yusuf. And then أَنَّكُمْ سَتَتُوبُونَ مُسْتَقْبِلًا مِنْ هَذَا الذَّنْبِ. Then you are going to repent from this sin. وَتُصْبِحُونَ بَعْدَهُ مِنْ خِيَارِ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ. And then you will become the best of Allah's servant. So now that we are after Ramadan, let us continue in good. The Prophet said, وَأَتْبِعُ سِيَّةِ الْحَسَنَةِ تَنْحُهَا. When you do a sin, follow it with a good. But alhamdulillah, we did good in Ramadan, we should not follow it with a sin. إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر المسلمين في كل مكان في مشارق الارض ومغاربها يا رب العالمين. اللهم انا نسالك التمام العافيه والدوام العافيه والشكر على العافيه. ونسالك الغنى عن الناس ونسالك العافيه من كل بريه يا رب العالمين. ربنا ظلمنا انفسنا وان لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Yeah. آمين آمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون، وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
Arrange the rows, make sure the rows are straight, fill in any empty rows if there's one behind it, and turn off cell phones.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. فإن كنت في شك مما أنزلنا إليك فاسأل الذين يقرؤون الكتاب من قبلك لقد جاءك الحق من ربك فلا تكونن من الممترين ولا تكونن من الذين كذبوا بآيات الله فتكون من الخاسرين إن الذين حقت عليهم كلمة ربك لا يؤمنون ولو جاءتهم كل آية حتى يروا العذاب الأليم فلولا كانت قرية آمنت فنفعها إيمانها إلا قوم يونس لما آمنوا كشفنا عنهم عذاب الخزي في الحياة الدنيا ومتعناهم إلى حين ولو شاء ربك لآمن من في الأرض كلهم جميعا أفأنت تكره الناس حتى يكونوا مؤمنين وما كان لنفس أن تؤمن إلا بإذن الله ويجعل الرجس على الذين لا يعقلون قل انظروا ماذا في السماوات والأرض وما تغني الآيات والنذر عن قوم لا يؤمنون فهل ينتظرون إلا مثل أيام الذين خلوا من قبلهم قل فانتظروا إني معكم من المنتظرين ثم ننجي رسلنا والذين آمنوا كذلك حقا علينا ننجي المؤمنين الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
قل يا أيها الناس إن كنتم في شك من ديني فلا أعبد الذين تعبدون من دون الله فلا أعبد الذين تعبدون من دون الله ولكن أعبد الله الذي يتوفاكم وأمرت أن أكون من المسلمين وأن أقم وجهك للدين حنيفا ولا تكونن من المشركين ولا تدع من دون الله ما لا ينفعك ولا يضرك فإن فعلت فإنك إذا من الظالمين وإن يمسسك الله بضر فلا كاشف له إلا هو وإن يردك بخير فلا راد لفضله يصيب به من يشاء من عباده وهو الغفور الرحيم قل يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم الحق من ربكم فمن اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه ومن ضل فإنما يضل عليها وما أنت عليهم بوكيل واتبع ما يوحى إليك من ربك واصبر حتى يحكم الله وهو خير الحاكمين
الله
سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله